where this is the weight loss webinar. And like I said a minute ago, we've put a lot of good information together and looking forward to sharing with you now. That's me on the left. I'm the author and founder of Real Food for Life. And with me here is Randy Fritz.
Hi, everyone. I give you my welcome, too, and we hope to have a great time this evening.
All right.
So we actually, when we sent out the email, we asked people to, you know, tell us a little bit about your weight loss and dieting history. And we couldn't write them all in, but we've got a few here, and these are sort of quite almost typical, I would say.
Yes, we didn't write everyone down, but you can see that many people are dieting and having a bit of, you know, but haven't always been successful. So I really appreciate the one that said that she's dieted around 30 to 50, 35 times. I thought, wow, that's a lot of time.
Good for you to keep sticking in there.
And then we've got one more page of this, don't we?
And yeah, and so people definitely are trying, and at least that's what counts. And we're hoping to show you some ways to make that more effective. And here is our question about sort of health situation, because we kind of lump weight loss and health together, and so we ask if people were have any particular food health challenges too, and we again, this is actually fairly common. There was a number of fibromyalgia people, and we have celiac disease, wanting more energy, better self-esteem, and this to me is a thoughtful reply. My biggest challenge is myself and getting motivated. So we appreciate those kind of comments.
Yes, it was good to hear some of your replies, so we don't feel like we're alone out here working with you.
Right. So the people that are maybe on the call right now, I'll ask that question again. If you can put a one word answer, yes or no. Have you tried to diet before? Just say yes. Okay. So we're getting yeses right away. And how many people on the call actually do have some health challenges that they have in mind also when they're looking at this?
Okay, well, lots of people have certainly.
Okay, we're getting all yeses. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Well, that's quite. That's good. Ah, I like that one. Not yet, but just want to stay healthy. Great. That's a really good place to come from. That's great.
So this is a weight management seminar. So we're going to start the talk around that, but you'll see how it evolves into other situations too.
And yeah, it is a world problem, this whole weight issue. I was quite surprised when I read when I was doing some research last week or the week before, and 2 billion people in the world are overweight. And two-thirds of the Americans over the age of 20 are overweight. That's pretty sad. And one-third of the Americans over the age of 20 are obese. Now, that really is I find that very, very sad, because when you're that big, it's, you know, quite difficult to get around. And the fact that obesity has now been classified as by the American Medical Association as a disease, is very interesting. So it's become something very difficult for the world to deal with. And this I found really interesting. Randy did some fun stuff here. This is I found this worldometer, and this is the number of obese people in the world. 526,558,966 on Sunday, September 8th. That was on Sunday.
Okay, now I'm going to go forward, Diana, and
yes?
remember the second set of numbers, 558 million people. We'll go forward to today, and it's jumped up in just 5 days to 623 million. So we're going to go back on the money spent in terms of obesity just 5 days ago on a yearly basis is $217 billion. And today, just 5 days later, it's gone now up to $295 billion because there's that many more overweight and obese people in the world. So if you're overweight, it's certainly you're not alone, and you shouldn't necessarily sort of feel that you're the only one or that it's all your fault.
No. And it's a problem for all of us, you know, if we have any overweightness at all, we just don't feel as good as we'd like to, you know, and having low energy, it just comes with it, because it's all those extra pounds that we're carrying around, and as we know, there's an increased risk for, you know, all kinds of diseases like diabetes and heart disease and almost every major illness. And the worst part is when clothes don't fit. All of us women know what that feels like. We don't like that. And, you know, there's just kind of, you know, really a lowering of your self-esteem. And there's a whole thing about being judged, too. You know, I know that when I was very, very sick, I used to get judged for being sick. And it wasn't very nice, you know. I remember walking by a stand in a market and some things were falling down. Had I been better, I would have caught them. But because I was sick, I couldn't. I just stepped out of the way and the person got really angry with me. How come you didn't catch them? And I got yelled at. So, yeah, it's not very nice. And, you know, the other thing about this whole overweight thing is that, you know, everywhere you see the models and the stars are all slim. And half the time it's not just slim, but they're skinny, which isn't even healthy, but it makes you feel like you have to be really skinny, but that's not it either. And studies show that you don't get as good service in stores when you're overweight. Isn't that interesting, huh?
Yeah, there's a big sort of public image about it, even though somehow we make it bad, and yet we're all in the same boat.
Yeah.
Now, Diana, you've had your own health challenges, certainly. Maybe you want to talk about that a little bit.
Well, I started out basically as an unhealthy child. I was always sick as a child, always getting something or other. You know, there was nothing majorly wrong, just always not very well. And then as I got older, I still struggled all through my teens and my 20s with health issues, and I ended up with quite severe chronic fatigue syndrome. I was sick with that for 15 years, and I lived on disability for 10 of those years. And I really realized that what I got to be was a disabled person with chronic fatigue and fibromyalgia was the combination. And I did totally recover from it, but it was not without a lot of work at it, but I did do it, and I'm very, very happy to this day that I got better back in 2001, and I'm still better. But, you know, what I have seen is that I do have a sensitive body, very sensitive, and I need to be someone of these people who just takes care. As long as I take care of myself, I'm usually healthier than most people around my age. I find that I just have to do that extra little bit. I don't drink alcohol. I don't eat a lot of sugar. I do eat healthy foods, and I stay healthy, and that's important to me. I don't do it because I want to be this shining example or some good girl or something. I do it because it does make me feel not so good not to do the right things, and I want to feel healthy and vibrant all of the time. So that's what it is. And which I think a number of women here who will probably relate to this is that, you know, since menopause, I have found that, you know, it's taken me a little bit of extra work to keep the pounds off. I was always a slender, skinny person almost, you know, without any effort at all when I was young. And after menopause, I noticed that those pounds just didn't come off so easily. So I've had to work at that a bit more. And
I like to refer to Diana as the human Geiger counter, as the human stethoscope. You're so sensitive that, you know, you're a gauge for everyone else. Everyone can use you as a gauge if something's good for you.
Yeah.
And so Diana is, as she said, she got over her fibromyalgia, she got over her chronic fatigue, she got over being basically disabled, but she's used that knowledge to go out and help other people. And she's the founder and author at Real Food for Life. She's taught cooking classes worldwide. She does private nutritional counseling. And she creates the most amazingly healthy recipes and menus. And I have to emphasize that because almost everyone listening probably has been on the Real Food for Life site, and you might not recognize just how much work and how much thought and how much balance goes into those recipes that Diana is providing for you. They're totally amazing. There are not other recipes like that on the internet.
Yes, I never see gluten-free recipes and sugar-free recipes that really come up to my high standards of what I think is healthy. So I actually spend hours creating each one because I'll do it, and sometimes it's not exactly the way I want it, so I have to do it again and again and again. So I can do a recipe between 3 to 5 times is my average amount of time for each recipe because I want to just get it really.
And how I have a saying again for Diana, if it's good enough for Diana, if it meets her standards, then it's good enough for everyone. It's good enough for everyone listening to this thing. You shouldn't feel that, I'm more sensitive or something like that. No, it'll be great for you.
In case you're wondering what I'm eating
Diana,
in that picture.
You've been very busy.
Oh, sorry, I was going to say
also around the world on the internet.
Yes, that's I started hosting healthy cooking and healthy living on Care2, which is a huge organization, and as you can see, the groups that I host there are big, over 400,000 each one of them, and there's a lot of activity that goes on there, and it's been a fun place to be, and it was where I kind of started out learning a lot more and helping a lot more, many more people this way by hosting those groups.
Yeah, so you're at the center of a lot of information.
Yes.
A lot of, sort of proven information and a lot of brand new stuff.
Yes. And if I don't know something, sometimes other people will know things. It's kind of fun.
And here are a few people that you've helped.
Yes, I think there's one person here who's the mother of one of them, and she'll recognize that. And this is, So there, I try to be helpful.
Right. So Cindy says Diana's helped her to live a happier, more energetic, and pain-free life. That pain-free and the energy is the thing that a lot of people want. And I know Kevin. I know this guy. Mm-hmm. He says Diana has been instrumental in helping make healthy choices every day. He's a great guy. Oh, there's me.
That's our Randy Fritz, who's been doing a lot of talking about me. Let me talk about him a little bit. He's been a very busy guy in this world of health since 1979. He's a certified nutritional consultant. He's the co-founder of Real Food for Life, and he is the founder of Vital Health Assessment, which is a great tool.
Yes, and I'm going to explain that a little bit. Like Diana and many people in this field, I got involved because I had my own health challenges. And my biggest question was, like, well, what do I do? What's good for me? When you're brand new, you don't know anything. And after you're sort of more experienced, you realize that everyone's telling you a different story. And so we created Vital Health Assessment. And what it can tell you is whether a food is good for you, whether a supplement is good for you. And it answers the question. It's like this is about 10 or 12 times. The average report we send out has about 50 to 200 different measurements. And so we've answered the question, what is good for me, about 900,000 times. And it's all done manually. Now, one of the things I've seen from this is that everyone is different. Everyone, like that's kind of the basis of this whole testing, is that everyone has different needs. Maybe some people need less carbohydrates. Some people need more protein. Some people need more essential fatty acids. And every single person is unique. And that's why a lot of weight loss systems don't work, because they just give you a small set of rules which you have to fit into, and it just doesn't work for you. And so we try to go that extra mile to make sure we find things that will fit into people's lives, and we use principles that work for everyone. And this is probably the most basic principle at all of health and life, is that the body heals itself in amazing ways. And so I asked that question kind of just as a kind of a joke, like, are you alive? If you're listening to me right now, if you can hear my voice, you're alive. And that means, like, your body is doing amazing things, you won the game of life, and there's a power in you that keeps that going. And sometimes we call it regeneration, sometimes we call it life. And I've been amazed that what can happen with people, you know, that power that is within every one of us right now. And here's a few people sort of from my life. This first person, I don't need to write anything down. This is an old friend of mine from Edmonton here. And this is a person who lost 300 pounds, got extremely healthy. And that second picture is one that I took shortly after he participated in one of my very first weight loss courses. And this other picture actually is someone, I think she's on the call right now. And this is a quote from her from one of our detox or cleansing sessions where, you know, we actually cut down your food intake quite a bit. But as you can see, she says, I wasn't hungry or having cravings at any time. And now she's down a few pounds, and she just loves Diana's recipes. And So does everyone else. Thank you very much for saying that, June, if you're listening. So this is the you know, sort of the big secret for all of us, is that, you know, no matter where you are, if you're alive right now, your body is striving for balance. And disease and being overweight is just a sign of imbalance. And I really like that pile of rocks because, you know, it has to be in balance. And each one of those rocks could represent something. Like maybe the top rock that's the lightest, maybe that's your emotional balance. Maybe that can get knocked off really easy. Maybe the second rock is your hormonal balance. Maybe the third rock is your blood sugar balance. And so my pile of rocks, if this was my pile of rocks, I've got a certain kind of balance in my life right now. My pile of rocks would look different from your pile of rocks. And I'm sure if we had Diana's pile of rocks, it would be a very tall, very sensitive looking pile. And so we're all just trying our best, and there's a number of areas that we can look at to create balance, and that's what we'll be talking about in this teaching tonight, is what we think are the most important principles for balance. So, Diana, you recently published an article in Real Food called The 10 Most Fattening Foods.
Yes, as you can see what they are. There's all when a lot of times people, use artificial sweeteners thinking that they're saving calories, but actually the truth is that artificial sweeteners actually help you to gain weight. So that's not a good idea. And of course we know about white sugar. And cheese, of course, isn't necessarily totally bad. It's just that when you eat too much of it, that's the thing. And most gluten-rich foods, they just have too much stuff in them in gluten-free products. They have way too much, usually white stuff in them. They're usually filled with starch and sugars, which aren't good. And potatoes. I was very surprised to find that potatoes, according to some studies, was the top food to make us fat. That was very interesting. Would have never thought that. And
yeah, that's really surprising.
So maybe there needs to be more research done on that one. I don't know.
No, we're not saying like these are all horrible foods and a little bit's going to kill you or puff up your
like
body.
We're just talking about fattening foods.
Yeah, and they're fattening because they cause some kind of imbalance. Like sugar causes an imbalance in your blood sugar system, alcohol, we haven't got there. There's alcohol. Alcohol puts an imbalance into your liver and your chemistry and all these other foods. Okay.
So here's another thing that I found very interesting. It'd be good if you got around to reading the article that I wrote, because it does give you much more detail. But alcohol, who would have thought that just alcohol without any of the stuff in it would actually help create more weight? And of course we know white carbs are, all know that. Deep fried foods and baked food goods, well, of course that all makes sense. Processed foods like bacon and processed meats, like bacon, and processed foods, I guess, like prepared dinners and things, like microwave dinners, most of those are not a good idea. So if you want to stay healthy, I'd stay away from those kinds of things.
Okay, so the question is, Diana, probably a lot of these things most people have, they kind of know, hey, maybe that's not so good for you, or eating too much for you. So how do you, if it's a good idea to reduce or eliminate, how do you do that?
Well, it's basically a matter of adding the very good foods, and what we like to add in are what we call power foods. And if you can increase those, then basically the cravings for the other ones start going away. So just the idea is to get in as many of these really good power foods as you can, and that way you'll start moving forward with your in eating better.
Yeah, now power foods, many of these are simple things that are available in your grocery store. They've been proven throughout centuries of use. And if you go onto our website, you'll actually read all the amazing things that apples do or strawberries do or kiwi do. Everyone has unique antioxidants and different anti-inflammatory chemicals. It's really, really just amazing what these foods have in them, the power of power foods. And I should say that although Diana didn't come up with the word power foods, I think she's been instrumental in popularizing the name on the internet. She's
it's true. Nobody was using it on Twitter until I started, and it became a great huge following.
And one of our ideas is that if you actually knew all the value of a strawberry or a zucchini, that when you ate it and you were actually aware of that, that it might help you to some degree, that you might actually get more nutrition and more benefit out of it, and you wouldn't eat so fast and that kind of thing. So now we're going to go on to some really important principles for balance. And the first one is one of Diana's favorites.
Yes, acid-alkaline balance. It's one of those things that when I was very sick, I was with a doctor that really taught me about this, a natural doctor, and I really learned firsthand how it really affects you. And the basic premise of this is that the cells in our body are approximately 20% acid and 80% alkaline. And we need to keep that balance. And to keep that balance, we need to eat approximately 20% acid-forming foods and 80% alkaline-forming foods. Otherwise, we'll get out of balance and things will happen and we will start getting sick. And the other thing that we'll concentrate a little bit more here, because people have come more to hear about losing weight and that sort of thing. So what we have discovered is that if you have an excess of acidity, you do end up getting fat. And when there is this excess of acids in the body, the acid breaks down the healthy tissue as well. And then the body, wanting to protect itself, uses and creates a natural buffer of fat. And the fat is to help to actually protect the body from all the acid. Because what we have discovered from our analysis is from the vital health assessments, we have discovered that most people are too acidic. And
about 95 to 97.
Yeah, and whenever I talk to anybody, I can always see quite quickly that they do have, that their diet is almost always too acidic. And, you know, so of course then that's where you get this natural buffer of fat going in there to protect it. So this is a very important principle to understand. And it's very difficult to lose weight, you know, when the body is too acidic. So, and the other thing is it's also very difficult to be healthy when your body is acidic. So it's a very important principle to get. This is just a little snippet about it, but give you a little bit of an idea. I wrote a whole e-book about it, actually.
Right, yeah, that's on our site. It's just a few dollars. And I'm just going to ask everyone, just say yes. Type in yes if you have heard about acid alkalinity before. And you could say no if you haven't. Okay, we're getting all kinds of yeses. Okay, so we've got a smart bunch. If you haven't, you can say no too. I was going to ask a little question. Like, I know, Diana, that you can actually just feel in your body when you're too acidic.
I can actually.
Okay.
If I've been out all day and for some reason I've had I've been at luncheons and things like that and I've eaten a little bit too acidic foods, I come home and I just want to eat a salad. I just want to have alkaline foods right away.
Okay.
Really interesting, yeah.
So my question for the group, and this will be interesting, is that this is actually not necessarily about acid alkalinity, but just balance in general. Can you tell, just from a feeling in your body, that you're somehow out of balance? Or does a doctor have to tell you that there's a problem? How many people on the thing, okay, so they can people can feel it. And so Diana can feel a number of things, including acid alkalinity, but everyone can feel that being out of balance. And this acid alkalinity is just one of them, and we want to sort of try to deal with a few major ones.
Yeah, and I think I think it's us women are pretty good at this kind of thing, Randy.
Oh yeah, women are. men are mostly just blocks of wood. And so this is sort
part
of the details.
Chart. Yeah. And this is like basically, what we need to do, most of us would need to do is that being in balance and being too acidic, we need to put more alkaline foods in to restore that proper balance. And you can see this is just part of the charts that are in the book. This is just there's more than this, but it just shows you all the, you can see which are the most alkaline foods and which are the most acidic foods, and then you can, and it doesn't mean that acidic foods are all bad. It's just a matter of getting the balance right. It's all about balance. You want to restore
right,
proper
yeah.
balance.
So you want to eat more from the right side of that list.
Yeah.
But even that seems sort of a little bit complicated, Diana. If you were to summarize it in just a few things, could you give us some tips how to stay more alkaline?
Well, you know, rather than going into a whole lesson on it right now, which would probably take at least half an hour, the main thing is that if you eat one big salad every day, that is going to really help you with being more alkaline. And you see that bowl of salad there? That was one of my meals. I ate that whole thing all by myself.
Yeah, and that bowl is as big as a dinner plate.
It's
not one of those little restaurant things, you know.
No, and it's deep enough, too. It's a few inches deep. So, mm-hmm. yeah. And I do eat out of that bowl a whole salad quite regularly. No problem.
Yeah. I eat one or two of those a day. For
yeah,
sure, you, one.
But yours are mostly just
two.
Lettuce, right, Randy?
Yeah, I'm a lettuce man.
He fills up a whole bowl with lettuce and just a couple of other things. Me, I put in all this other stuff, and I have lettuce in it.
But the greens is the most alkalizing part.
That's
isn't
right.
Not?
They
That's
are.
Right.
Greens are the most alkalizing for sure. But they don't fill you up enough, so you need a few other things to.
Maybe that's why I have to eat two salads. Okay, another tip.
And then another one is to start your day with a glass of lemon water, and you can drink the lemon water whenever you want, actually. But the lemon water is lemons are the most alkaline forming food that you can eat or drink. So that's why it's good to dip the lemons in there. So if you get greens and you get lemons in. So this is just a couple of quick tips, something that you can do really easily.
Like you could this lemon is so easy. Like if you have a lemon in your fridge right now, you could after the call you could go have some lemon water. It would help your digestion. If you're in a restaurant, you can ask for hot water and lemon. And the next time you're at a grocery store, just make it a thing to buy a bag of lemons. I have to buy them by the bag because I eat one or two lemons a day.
Yeah, I buy them by the bag too. In fact, I came to this call with my glass of lemon water.
Right.
I just finished it a few minutes ago.
So that actually might be the real tip. Buy lemons in bags, not one at a time.
Oh, yes. You have to have a bag of them. And they last quite well. And you can always keep them in the fridge too.
And here is the second principle to balance and healthy weight loss.
Yes, to get this better digestion. It's so important. This sort of thing really saved my life. I really learned a lot from this. Again, it was from the same natural doctor that helped me to get stabilized from going downhill.
Now, in the subject of weight management, Diana, a lot of people think, well, my digestion is pretty good. That's why I'm overweight. I don't want to. If my digestion gets better, I'll even get more overweight.
Yes, that's not the case at all. It's not it, for sure. Because the thing is that usually what happens with when you're overweight, there's like a way that you're always hungry. You're always kind of craving things. And it's basically coming from the fact that you're probably not getting all the nutrition from the food that you're eating. And what you need to do is get that nutrition. So better digestion will mean that you'll get more nutrition from the food. And that's the whole thing. A lot of the time when we're starving ourselves in some way, or we're craving things all the time, we're going back and forth and we're eating all this stuff, and it's just not well combined with itself. It's not balanced.
Right, and the reason I put that picture of there of the fire in the belly is that your digestion kind of works like a fire, and the fire is also your metabolism. You need fire to burn up your fat. And so the stronger your digestion / fire, the higher your metabolism, and the more you're going to burn off weight. So what are the basic ideas behind food combining?
Well, that's the whole thing. Like this is the whole food combining principle, and I often avoid even talking about it too much, because it is quite complex when you get right into it. So what we're going to do is I'm going to just stay very simple right now. So because again, this is the kind of class that would take me a good hour to really go into in a lot of detail.
And we do get into detail in some of our other classes.
Yeah, we'll go into more detail in the classes, but right now let's get some simple principles. And basically, there's some combinations of foods that don't digest well together. And there's some combinations of foods that do digest well together. So the ones that don't digest well together, they actually fight with each other and cause a problem in the digestive systems. And why does this happen? Well, basically, the different foods are actually digested at different times and places within your body, within your digestive system, and they require very specific enzymes to make that happen.
Yeah, the body's really smart. It's not just like throwing stuff into a furnace.
No.
It's much more sophisticated than that.
Yeah.
So some tips,
well,
Diana.
Well, the basic thing is that what you want to do is keep your proteins and your carbs separate from each other, because they fight with each other for digestion. So you make your meal either a protein meal with veggies or a carb meal with veggies. And the main principle here is do not have carbs and protein in the same meal. And I know that's quite conflicting with the average meat and potatoes sort of diet, but it's better if you... because you want that 80% alkaline and 20% acid too. So then you see, if you have a whole meal that is like based on either carbs or veggies or protein and veggies, then you'll get it right.
You know, I had to hear this probably 10 or 20 times before it finally sunk in. No, I can just have protein and veggies, or I can have carbs. I just automatically just... You know, we always just throw them all together, and it's so much simpler and easier on you if you just don't throw them together.
Yeah, and if you're if you're having your protein meal, if you're going to have, you know, if you're saying having some fish with some veggies or some eggs with some veggies, or you know, or if you're having your brown rice with some veggies, you know, that kind of thing, and then
just remember the veggies.
Yes, but always have the veggies. That's the main thing. And then the other tip is tip number two, to make things really simple, is...
Oopsie, Diana got kicked off again. And so I'll wait till she gets on, but I'll just finish, keep talking. Eat your fruits alone, and... This will be hard quite a bit, and there are a few exceptions, but, you know, it's fruit to me is kind of a snack food anyway. Maybe you don't make a whole meal out of it, And so you just keep it away from your meals. You don't just necessarily have to go there. So we're going to have a little quiz, everyone. I don't know if you can see that, but that shrimp and noodles of some kind and a few veggies. Now the question is, and you can type this in, is this a good combination? Is this a good food combination?
Sorry, I don't know what's going on, but I've never been booted out of the call before.
Yeah, it's the first time, but it's picking you out for particularly. It doesn't like you, Diana.
No, don't say that. I don't know what's going on. I've never seen that happen before. I was wondering whether it was my phone, but I don't think so.
Okay, every single person, we just had our quiz.
Oh, we've got smart people here. Oh, and if you don't eat fish or meat of any sort, yes, of course, then it really doesn't work. And just so you know that all the classes that I teach, we do actually, I don't teach about eating meat. I have places where if you want to, you can add in some fish or chicken, but I don't. The menu doesn't have any fish or chicken or any meats in it at all. I don't do that. Yeah, so
yeah,
you don't have to be worried. If you're vegan, all my classes are vegan, so don't worry about
right.
it at all. Yeah, absolutely. Because I
And I don't know if every single recipe on the site, everything that comes from you is vegan, I would assume.
Yeah,
but
there's
I've
had a few recipes that have had yogurt in them in the past.
Oh, okay.
And I think even one time I had some eggs in something. But
okay.
Normally I don't do that. I keep it out. And if that was a long time ago that I had those. I don't have them anymore.
Okay. So it looks like we have a lot of vegans on the call at the moment.
Yeah. Did you finish that thing with the?
Yes, I did. Sorry, Diana.
Okay. Good. Okay.
Somebody mentioned you were doing a lot of clicking before that you got kicked off. So it might actually be your phone line too.
It could be. I'll have to see. I don't know what's going on.
Okay, so the final sort of principle is that your body was meant to move. And to keep your body healthy and happy, you need to move. And this is not about burning calories. It's about keeping the circulation in your body going. If the blood doesn't circulate, if the lymph doesn't circulate, that's when the toxins, dig in little places and turn into acid. And so you don't have to be fanatical about this. And again, it's not about, well, if I run an hour, I burn off 50 calories. That kind of thinking, it's just totally irrelevant. It's more about balancing your body and get it, sort of working, getting that fire going. So we suggest, and we'll be sort of talking more about this in other trainings, I'm going to make a video of it. 5 minutes of vigorous exercise every day in the home. And this is where you're moving quickly or you're actually pushing, your muscles are working a little bit. It doesn't have to be a lot.
And it's not too vigorous. We're not going to too hard.
But like a lot of studies have shown that intermittent exercise and or varying exercise is a lot more beneficial to you than every day doing the same exercise over and over and over. Now, the next thing's taking walks. It's almost like walking should almost not be considered an exercise. It's just our natural state. The human body, before we had cars and planes and that, like people walked and walked and walked all the time. And it's a kind of an exercise, but it's something that we should be doing every day. Okay, so Diana, you were in Europe.
Yes, so I was over there. I was reading one of the some information in a magazine that was all about health, and I discovered that they had done some research and they'd come up with this 2-5 diet, and it's a form of intermittent fasting. And I found it quite interesting. There was a whole studies on it and how much people actually really lost weight when they did this. And I thought, well, now that sounds interesting. Because guess what? I'm a woman, and I like to know about that kind of stuff. And so I read about it and got going, and I thought, well, basically what it comes down to is you do part-time dieting for 2 days a week only. That's it. And then you do, for those 2 days, it's a low-carb eating, and it makes it a lot easier to do this than to stick with continuous dieting all week long. And then the other 5 days, you don't just go off into the junk food realm of life. You still eat sensibly, but you're not kind of restricting as much. You're being a lot looser with it all. And so that was very inspirational, and that was the inspiration for this course that we're doing. And then what we've discovered is that the scientists found that people lose more weight and more belly fat when restricting food intake for short periods than when on a continuous diet. Now, that's interesting, isn't it? Because I've heard a lot of people say that they've tried dieting and it hasn't worked. And so this intermittent fasting is basically the key here. And also,
right, yeah.
You know what they... Yeah, and they found also that the risk of diabetes was just slashed. So that was really good to see here, too.
So, yeah, it balances out your blood sugars amazingly.
Yeah.
So this is what happens.
Yeah, and it's low calories of 500 to 600 calories is what they're suggesting, and it's healthy with no junk food. Basically, we don't go down that low. I don't go into calories. I don't talk about calories, and I'm not going to go there because I feel like calories is a very restrictive way of thinking about things. It's basically that you eat less on those days, and you have no junk food, and then on the other 5 days, it's sensible eating. And so their recommendation is a little bit hard to do. I think it could be kind of too hard, really.
Yeah. Now, I'm just going to back up a bit, and I would just say that the other reason why I perked up when I heard this was because that's what Diana had been talking about before she became aware of this. This 2-5 diet is becoming all the rage. I know, I'll ask that question. How many people have heard of the 2-5 diet before, without getting it from us? Has anybody say no or yes? Okay, a lot of no's. Yeah, it started in Europe. It's just coming into North America. Big movie stars and stuff are starting to go on it, so you'll probably hear more about it. But what I twigged on when Diana was telling me, well, gee whiz, that's exactly what we've been doing with our trainings, because most of our trainings, a lot of them are detoxes or alkalizing sort of programs. They were always for 2 days at a time. And so I think that Diana was even ahead of the curve on this.
Well, for one thing, we always say to people, detox weekends, not to do it all week long. It really is only for
right,
2 days.
Yeah.
And I often say that you can redo it next weekend or whatever 2 days you want. You don't have to do them on weekends, but just no more than 2 days a week. So I found that interesting that is actually already what we were doing. So that's good.
Right, yeah. And now if you're sort of, we can't spend a whole lot more time on this intermittent fasting, but, you know, if you want to start Googling and stuff, you can look around and you'll find more information on it. We don't agree personally with a lot of things a lot of people are doing, and sometimes the foods that they're using is not that particularly healthy when they're going on their two-day stuff. But forgetting all that, if this sort of idea sort of attracts you and this sounds good, the obvious problem with any kind of diet or fasting or cleanse or any kind of change that you go through is often we find it hard to get started and to stick with it. So I'll ask that question to the group. Have anybody found that problem, like sticking with something, either starting or sticking? You can write in. We have a few questions. The sticking. Most people are sticking. Oh, okay, the sticking is okay. So
one thing we just answer here is like what's the difference between a sensible eating and low calorie? Well, usually what happens when people get stuck on low calories is that they're thinking too much of low calorie, and it's not necessarily always that sensible. You could decide that you're going to have less calories, but you're going to eat this thing that's got a lot of calories in it, but then you won't hardly eat anything else all day because you've eaten this one thing that's got lots in it. And I'm more into just getting into sensible eating so that it becomes more of a habit. The idea of creating sensible eating habits is good in the long run, because then you just change the whole way that you're eating and drinking.
Right, yeah. And so we hope we've sort of inspired you to that it is possible to be more healthy, that there is principles and stuff like that. And a lot of this information, if you want, there's tons of wonderful recipes and knowledge and stuff on our website, Real Food for Life. But we wanted to talk to you now about like what we feel is where we can help people to sort of move forward on to the next step. And sometimes it you can have this kind of information, and we hope it's been useful this evening. But what we like to do is offer personal and group support for your goals, not just kind of buying a book on the internet or from the store and trying to do it yourself. Like I've had several people say, well, you know, I read the menu and I read this and I have a question and what do I do basically? And so we've been giving a number of courses that sort of just change that dramatically. And we've had a lot of experience at this, of giving courses and supporting people on the internet and through email. And like, for example, like that quote I gave, you know, the detoxes, people didn't feel hungry. Somehow Diana's recipes and her perfect balanced menus, like they were eating mostly watermelon or whatever it was, and they were not hungry. And so we have a system of providing menus and recipes and shopping lists for you, and we've been teaching this kind of support for decades and doing these online courses now with Real Food for Life for 3 years. So we wanted to tell you about our next major course, which we're really excited about. Diana, maybe you can.
Yes, what's happening is it's going to start on the weekend of September 20th, and the September 20th is a Friday, but for that weekend. And the idea is that we'll have a live webinar training on the 18th, which is a couple of days before. So that way it gives you a chance to, ask questions and get going. So that's on the Wednesday. And then basically what will happen is that you will eat whatever you like, but for only 5 days a week. And again, we're going to keep that somewhat, we're going to say the sensible thing there too, and there'll be a little too, you know, just talking about that without feeling really restricted and on a diet. And then just for 2 days a week, you'll follow the plan given to you in the workshop. And I've already created it for the first weekend and the next weekend. It's the week's 2 day menu will change slightly for fun and effectiveness. And
could I just ask Diana, like we've sort of explained the 2-5. Why we've got the number 30 in there?
Well, the whole idea of 30 is that it's going to. This is for a whole month. This is a month class. This is a healthy diet for a whole month. And because what I've actually really seen is that to really have results, we need to stick with something for a month. One weekend, it's good, it's helpful, but I've started to feel like doing the weekend things just didn't feel good enough for me. I want to help people move forward in a bigger way, and that's why I decided that a full month of classes, people would really benefit from that support. And
we want to revolutionize a person's life.
Yes, and that's what more likely can happen when you do it for a month. I mean, a lot of people have changed all kinds of things just from doing a weekend, for sure. It's not to say that nothing happens from that. For sure it does. But I know that people want to make something really solid in each person. And so that's what a full month is. And that's why we're calling it 2-5-30, 2 days a week.
Yeah. And so if you're doing it for a full month, like, you're sticking to it, and it's gonna change you.
Yeah.
So this is the question then, why the our real food for life 2-5-30 diet is different from, you know, typical diets or typical 2-5 diets?
Well, generally, you know, diets usually restrict calories, which really do starve the body. So I don't want anything that's going to make the body feel starved. And nobody will feel starving in any of this. I'm not good at walking around being hungry ever. So I don't expect anybody else to either. But you will be eating healthy things. And also you naturally don't want to stay on a diet. And that's why diets usually fail. Because who wants to be on a diet? And, you know, with this whole thing, your body will love it because it's actually nourishing the body. It's refreshing the body in a way that really needs going to be much more alkalized. It'll be food combined. It's good for the body.
You'll feel the balance.
Yeah, exactly. You'll feel the balance. And that's what the whole idea is we're going to create a very balanced way of eating. And you'll just naturally begin to gravitate towards eating better and better.
So that balance you feel in the 2 days will hopefully percolate out through the 5 days.
Yes, exactly. And it's basically what I've created here is basically a healthy, low-carb, gluten-free, and we could put vegan there, but because it is, but it has the option of people being able to add their fish and chicken in at various places if they want to.
And so why are we doing the gluten? Like, nobody else is doing that, Diana.
No, because you see, the thing is that most people don't realize that even if you don't think that you're gluten intolerant, most people do benefit from reducing gluten in their diet because gluten is actually fattening. That's the thing. So just to not have it during those 2 days is going to be good. And we've actually found in our testing that 95% of the individuals do not test well for wheat and other gluten products.
And again, that's probably a conservative figure. It's probably closer to 97 or 99.
Yes. People don't do as well with it as they think they are. You might have extreme, like you say, well, I don't get stomach aches from it. I don't have it. It might be that that's where the weight is coming from. One of the places where you're gaining weight may be from the gluten.
Right.
It might not show up as terms of stomach aches. Like for me, when I used to be exceptionally gluten intolerant, I'm not so gluten intolerant anymore, but when I was, I would just get bad stomach ache, really bad ones, you know. So I could tell right away because my digestive system would show it. But for some people that I've noticed that are gluten intolerant, they don't get stomach aches. They just get overweight, or they get
right,
hit,
yeah,
or all kinds of things happen. Other things happen.
And so again, this is if this menu is good for Diana, you know, I can say it will be good for you too. So we just want to go through some of the steps that, like, you know, if you sort of register for this, what actually happens?
Well, first of all, what you get is you'll receive a menu and a shopping list and recipes for the week one, which really isn't a whole week, it's just the 2 days. But you'll receive that, and you don't have to think about it at all. I'll also tell you that if there's anything on that list that for some reason you don't agree with, we do ask questions. We ask everybody at the beginning of when they register if they have any food sensitivities or allergies, and I will actually work with you on that one because I want everybody to be happy with that. And then you will shop for your food on a one quick trip, because it'll all be there on the shopping list, and then you will participate in live and taped video instruction.
You'll actually go through, you know, you'll sort
I'll
of talk
through.
People through the menu and stuff like that.
Yep, and then there'll be we'll be having 4 live classes during the whole month, plus you will get some tape video instructions that will come to you on some days too. And you get to choose the 2 days that work for you. The first time we're doing it on the weekend because it's just easier for me to gather everybody together on one time. So we'll do that. But if you want, you don't have to necessarily do it that weekend if you don't want. But
Actually, with one of the ideas behind this intermittent, it doesn't have to be consecutive days. Actually, a lot of the systems want you to be non-consecutive, but we're okay with consecutive.
I think it's easier to do it for 2 days in a row,
right,
but
yeah.
You know, just because it gets you onto a room. I'm going to suggest the way we're doing it is we're going to do it for 2 days together,
right,
if
yeah.
we can. But if you want to separate them, of course you can. But I'm going to suggest that we keep them together.
And I'll just emphasize that last point, is that to have access to Diana, to ask her questions about this, is just a tremendous, tremendous resource. And you can also, we also like to have people ask their questions to the group, because the group is smart too.
Yeah, we're going to be setting it up in such a way that there's a bit of a mastermind group, a mastermind diet group, so we can be in support with each other. Because there's a lot of research that shows that when people work together, things work out a lot better for all of us. So there isn't just one person to talk to. There's other people too, and it feels really supportive. So you'll on week two you'll receive recipes with variations that you will help to create yourself, so that you can learn how to make some variations to make them more fun and healthy. And you'll receive nutrition lessons. And you'll get to decide what you want to do with some simple substitutions. And I'll go through that with you in the class. And, you know, so the week two will give you a variation and some more confidence to just be able to move forward on your own. And there's a picture of one of the kinds of recipes that you'll be getting in the classes.
Right. I think that's my smoothie.
Yes, it looks like it, because it looks like it's on one of your plates.
Right, yeah.
And then on week 3 and 4, you'll receive a new shopping list, menu, and recipes. And that'll help you to have you'll get a whole new thing going on so that you have basically very sensible foods and everything, but it'll be different so that you're not stuck with eating the same things all the time. And there'll be a new live training about your new program. And, of course, you can always ask me questions if you have any problems. I'll expect people to come with their questions and sometimes even send them to me in advance. And at the end of the whole week four, we will have another live training to see how people went and see whether there's how to move forward, what to do after that. What do you do on the second month?
Now, so basically the idea is there's lots of calls, there's lots of video training, there's lots of variation, but you're in control. Now, somebody, Jessie asked, that she said she works on weekends. It's not possible to do anything online then unless she can access it later.
Well, what we're doing is that we're not doing hardly any of the calls on the weekend. That's the good news. The first call is on Wednesday night.
Or Thursday night.
No.
I thought it was Thursday night.
No,
oh, sorry.
It's Wednesday night. It's Wednesday night. You've got it. You put it down as Wednesday night. So the first one's on Wednesday night. The second call is on the Sunday evening to wrap things up for after that first weekend. That one will be actually taped so that you will be able to go in and see the video and listen to it. So it will be there for all the class participants. And then the next class will be on a Wednesday that we have. So we will be keeping them on Wednesdays. We figured middle of the week was easier for most people, just in case they're busy on weekends. And Wednesday isn't the most lively night of the week, and it's not the end of the week either, so you still have some energy and it'll give you a chance to get things together by the weekend, to go through the shopping list with me and stuff like that.
Okay.
And so what the idea is that by the end of the month, you will have the skills and confidence to do this on your own, to achieve your goals. Because we want you to be able to get whatever you need to happen in your body to happen during that time.
Okay.
And, so that's it for that.
Yeah, and so normally a single two-day course can cost anywhere from $50 to $200 without the kind of individual attention you'll be getting from Diana. And therefore, four separate courses like this would cost $200 to $800. If you were getting that from anywhere else, we put literally hundreds of hours into every single one of these two-day things. For all four of these, the price for four modules is our regular price is $149. And believe me, that is a good deal. And so, but we have actually something, a special discount for people who are sort of eager enough to come on to the video and come on to the training, is the complete course of live trainings, recipes, menu, shopping lists, and support is until this Saturday, until midnight Saturday, you can get it for only $97. And
you do have to copy down that link there, the www.realfoodforlife.com/webinar8, and because we're not posting this online anywhere and we're not putting it in an email or anything, so you have
right
to
like if
here.
You go to our site and look up the 2530 diet, it'll have a button to buy it for $149.
But this,
so you're the only person that knows about this.
Yeah, the only people that only people right now that know about this discount are all of you who are in this webinar tonight, only people, and we are leaving it only for people until the end of Saturday
yeah.
midnight, and we will we're going to let this webinar be up for people to watch for till then.
If
as well.
We hope this was recorded, we really do, but you never
Hopefully.
Know.
you never know. It's happened to us before.
And so if we can put it up tomorrow until Saturday, we'll do that. Now, there was one question. I think the group, this is a good example of group support. Someone asked about, did you see the question about, what was it about yogurt, soy yogurt?
Yeah, I don't really have yogurt in the menu anyways. It won't be in the menu. And if you do want to use soy yogurt, it's totally fine. But it won't be in the menu. There's no yogurt.
Okay.
I've kept the menu vegan. I think that even people who eat meat, it's quite good to have a vegan weekend now and again, or a couple of days. And I will give you places where if you want to add some fish or chicken in, you can, but you don't have to.
Okay, and so if there's any questions,
this is the time
I'll start by asking if there's any questions that people want to type in.
But you can they can also unmute, right, so people can ask questions.
Well, no, I was going to have them type in first
and deal with that.
And then if once we've dealt with those or if there's none, we'll then unmute.
Okay, that sounds good.
Okay. So if anybody has any questions you'd like to type in, either about anything that we've covered in this evening, or if you'd like to make a comment, you can just jot that down right now.
Mm-hmm.
And in a minute or two, we're going to open up the thing, so if you actually want to talk with us, we like to hear your voices. And
yes.
That's always fun. Okay, so I don't see any questions yet, so I'm going to unmute all the group. Oopsie. Oh no, now we're having some.
The webinars will be taped if you cannot listen on Wednesdays. Yes, they will be, for sure.
Right, yeah.
And, yeah.
I'm actually a little confused about the dates. I should tell everyone that I'm a terrible speller, and sometimes I get little details wrong, and so if there's any problem, it's always me, not Diana. You can count on her.
This guy doesn't know how to. He does not know how to spell. But he's very good at that techie stuff behind things. One of the things is that for any of the courses that we take, we do tape them, and they are up for people. Everybody who's registered for the course, they can go in there. And they can listen to them at their own time. We prefer people to come to them when we're there, because then there's a chance to ask something right live in the moment. But sometimes it doesn't work, and you know that's okay. And if for any reason the taping wasn't successful, we will do it all by ourselves.
We would redo it. Yeah.
We will redo it. It has happened that at the end of a class we discovered it did not tape. And Randy and I had to go back in and do it all by ourselves and tape it again and do the whole class as if you were all there. So that wasn't too bad, though. And nobody knew, actually, because we made it really good.
Oh, I forgot to mention, Diana, that we do have a money-back guarantee, just the satisfaction. Like, we can't guarantee that you'll lose weight or you'll overcome all your health challenges, but somehow if you get into this and you're finding it's just not for you or it's just whatever...
Yeah.
You can just ask for your money back.
Yeah. And Ginny, yes, we can chat during the month if you come across a question about recipes or anything else. That's exactly why we do a full month support system. And I'm here, and I'll always be here.
Diana's on answering emails all the time.
Yes, I do. And if you miss the 25th call, you can still access it on the 28th, no problem. We will have them. Everything will be recorded and up. We will have everything available for everybody who's taking the course. So that won't be a problem. So, so do see at the bottom there that realfoodforlife.com/webinar8. If you want to be doing this, then you need to type that into your browser, and that will give you a chance to get that this $97. And like we said, only people on this call are getting this.
Right, yeah. So you don't want to miss out.
That's an exceptionally good deal for all.
I have to twist Diana's arm.
I didn't want to do it so cheap because I figure how much work I put in, all the hours and hours I put in. I put in for every weekend thing, I put in 100 hours. So I'm thinking I'm putting in 200 hours for this one, at least probably 250. I'm thinking, oh, yes, I want. So anyways.
But
it's all fun.
So I'm going to unmute in case anybody just wants to talk, or it seems like people are typing in, and that's good, but I would just unmute people and see what happens. Okay, so what I can see on the thing, people are sort of liking this idea, and they're sort of enjoying the evening. We really hope that you've got something out of it, either the kind of information and inspiration that we started with, and for some of you that might be enough, you know, and just to get you going. But if you want to take another step and sort of really get into it, then we invite you to take part in the upcoming training, because we're excited as heck about it. And
yeah,
it's starting soon.
Yes, this next weekend. Not this one, but the weekend after, so there's plenty of time to get ready for it.
Okay. So if there's no more questions, this is your last chance for questions. If you want to type them in now, now's the time, or we're going to, it's getting close to 8:30, which is not too bad.
Well, thank you everyone for coming and participating this evening. And I look forward to seeing some of you in the class, 5:30 class.
Okay. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Thank you for coming.
Yes. Good night, and thank you.